Good morning students. In the previous class we have started Law and Justice, a case study. So already we discussed about a small dispute between Ravi and Samba. Okay, so Ravi sold the plot to other person, and Samba went to police station against the Ravi. So the FIR was filed, and Ravi also taken into custody by the police. So later what will happen we will discuss. So civil and criminal offenses. So here, when any person done mistake, so that mistake may be either it is belongs to civil or criminal. So here, the next day Ravi talked to the SI. So he want to compromise, and he want to return the money to Samba, and he want to settle his dispute without going to court. Okay, so but the SI answered that you will have to pay that money anyway, but now you are arrested for beating him up. This is a criminal case now. So if you had not assaulted Samba, the police would not have been involved, and Samba would have filed a civil case against you for not giving the plot. Then you could have returned his plot and paid compensation for the loss incurred by him. In that case, you would not have been sent to jail. So what the SI replied? So here Ravi involved in a criminal case by beating Samba. So in the civil case, mostly the police won't be involved, and the accused person won't to sent to jail. But in criminal case, they will punish by jail. So in this case, Ravi and Samba, there are two types of disputes. One is Ravi attacking Samba. This is a criminal offense. So theft, dacoit, adulteration, bribery, making spurious drugs, etc., are few other criminal offenses. Okay, what are comes under criminal offenses? Theft, dacoit, adulteration, bribery, making spurious drugs, or murder. These are also comes under criminal cases. There is also a civil offense between them. Ravi did not give the plot or return the amount that Samba had paid. So that is comes under financial or property disputes, comes under civil case. Civil cases are related to people's rights over land, property, income, and people's relationships with each other. So these are comes under civil cases. So in case of criminal disputes, people are often punished with a jail term, whereas in civil cases they may not be sent to jail. In criminal cases, the police will be involved, but in civil cases, the person should pay file a case in court only. Okay, a criminal case is always handled by the police and not by the person who suffered from the crime. On the other hand, a civil case is always lodged by a person who feels that he has suffered due to the cheating or breach of contract. Here, breach of contract means the agreement between two persons. Okay, so that is called, if it is not followed by any person, that agreement, that is called the breach of contract. In the criminal cases, the police will be investigate and prepare the charge sheet, and that will be submitted in the court. So why? Because it is a violation of law made by the government. So in criminal cases, the police involved. Why? Because it is a violation of law made by the government. In civil case, the violation is of an agreement between two people. It won't be affect the whole society. Okay, we can see here differences between criminal law and civil law. Already we discussed which are comes under criminal and which are comes under civil cases. Again, so here criminal law deals with conduct or act that the law defines as offenses. For example, theft, taking dowry, murder. So in these cases, police will be involved, comes under criminal law. Civil law deals with any harm caused to party due to breach of agreement by another individual. For example, rent, purchase of goods, divorce. So for these, disputes, so civil law will be involved. Next, in criminal law, it usually begins with lodging of an FIR and police investigation, and then the case is filed in the court. This is the procedure. So after disputes, so any one of the person will be filed the case against the other person, then FIR will be booked, later police will be investigate, later they prepare the charge sheet and submit in the court. This is the procedure in a criminal law. In civil law, a petition has to be filed before the court by the person who has been offended. For example, in a rent dispute, either the owner or tenant. So here, in civil case, the people won't visit the police station directly. They will file the case in the court. Next, in criminal case, if found guilty, accused can be sent to jail and also fined. Either jail or fine, sometimes they can impose both the punishments. Okay, but in civil law, court provides relief to the offended, like a house may be vacated by the tenant or dues get paid. So here there is no punishment, either jail or fine. So the person who are suffered get the relief. So like that, some differences are there between criminal and civil law. Next, bail. Already you know bail. So in the criminal cases, usually the accused person may send to jail. So at the time of punishment, they can get the, before or after the punishment, they can get the bail from the court. So since Ravi's case is a criminal case, so after being charge sheeted, Ravi was put in lockup. So before trial also, they will send to jail. In criminal cases, an accused is kept in jail, but this is not a punishment. So after judgment only, they will give the punishment. This is only to help in the process of investigation as well as to prevent him or her from tampering with evidence or threatening the witness, etc. So why the Ravi kept in jail before the judgment? So because, so one is that is the process of investigation. Second one is, so if he was outside, definitely he will be threatening or influence the people, either witness. So that's why he was kept in jail. So after some days in judicial custody, his family appeared in the court to get a bail from him. So the process is getting late. So usually family members approach the court for bail. A person who is accused of serious crimes like murder, bribery, dacoity, etc. may not get a bail. So those are called non-bailable offenses. So in serious cases, the person won't get the bail. Even in some cases, so many ministers were not got the bail for more than one year or 2 years. Okay, so Gali Janardhan Reddy in Karnataka, one of the mining minister, was in jail more than 3 years without getting bail. So in some cases, they don't get the bail. So to get bail, certain sureties are to be given in the court. So anyone should give the surety, either property or personal surety you have to give to get the bail. So these sureties can be property or a person who will stand as guarantee or bond. The bond is a promise that offender will appear before the court whenever asked for. So the judge in the court can decide whether to go bail or refuse it. So after appeal for bail, so the judge can decide either he is eligible for bail or not. So at the time of bail time, the accused person should not travel another countries, and whenever they asked, he should present in the court. Okay, that is called bail. So bail as right of the accused. According to our constitution, bail is right of the accused. It will be granted basing on the gravity of the offense, based on the seriousness, severity of the case. Some are bailable cases, some are non-bailable cases. So possibility of threat to the witness. At the same time, the court will decide if the accused is released, whether there is any harm to the society, witness and complaint. So at the time, they don't allow the bail. In bailable offenses, only SHO, means SI, head of the police station, can give bail. So previously, actually, for every bail, the accused person should appeal to the court, but later that was changed, those rights given to the SHO of police station. Now again this was cancelled, and that powers given to court only. In case of non-bailable offences, the accused have to move bail petition before the appropriate court. So according to the sections, according to the severity of the case, some cases may be filed as non-bailable cases. Okay. So in a court, Ravi or Samba case is argued by lawyers. So when you present the case in the court, so there should be argued by the lawyers. Ravi will have to find his own lawyer. Why? Because he is a rich person and can appoint his own lawyer, engage his own lawyer. But Samba will get a public prosecutor or government lawyer. So who are not able to appoint a lawyer on behalf of them, the public prosecutor will argue. So legal procedure are complicated and special knowledge is needed to discuss them. So every person have right to argue their case in the court. They have a right, but it required some special knowledge. So that's why every person should appoint their own lawyer to argue in the court. So what is the role of the public prosecutor? Who is public prosecutor? So to help the poor and to argue on behalf of the government, one lawyer will be appointed by the government in every court. He is called a public prosecutor. Okay, so a criminal offense is registered as a public wrong against the society, against the public. This means that crime is committed not only against the victims, but against society as whole. So in court, it is the public prosecutor who presents the interest of the state. The role of the prosecutor begins after the police has conducted the investigation and filed the charge sheet in the court. So the prosecutor has no role to play in the investigation. Already we discussed in the previous class. So the investigation done by only police. Okay. Next, punishment will be given by only judge. Okay. So he or she must conduct the prosecution on behalf of the state as an officer of the court. It is his her duty to act impartially and present the full and material facts, witness and evidence before the court to enable the court to decide the cases. That these are the duties of public prosecutor. Okay, next, fair trial. So Samba and Ravi's case was to be heard in the court of the judicial magistrate. So lawyers in black robes. So every lawyer should wear so particular dress. Those are called robes. So people facing trial and many other people who had come to attend the hearing of other cases were present in and around the court. So for every case, the court will give some day for trial. So at the time, the accused person and opposed person should be present at the time in the court along with their lawyers. So at court, so many people may come to attend the different cases. So the rule of law says that everyone is equal before the law. This is more important. So according to law, so everyone is equal before the law, either rich or poor, or either this religion or that religion, either he is in any position. So everyone should be equal before the law. So before deciding if someone is guilty, so she or he will be allowed to a fair and impartial public hearing. So after filing a case against any person, so before deciding if he did the mistake or not, so he should be allowed to fair and impartial public hearing. He can say anything in the court. Criminal prosecution starts with the presumption of innocence and the guilt must be proved beyond reasonable doubt. The judge did not jump to the conclusion that Ravi was the criminal just because Samba was injured. It is to be proved that the injuries were made by Ravi. So the judge never conclude by seeing the bandage of Samba. Okay, you cannot conclude, you cannot jump into the conclusion. So either that injury was done by Ravi or not, that should be proved in the court. Then only the judge will be decide either Ravi is guilty or not. Okay, so next part of the lesson we will discuss in the next class.